hit bullseye, the kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it. Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Pass Math with Miss Passarella. I'm your favorite math teacher, Miss Passarella. Haven't made a video in a while. Emergency video today, that's why there's no green screen behind me. So I know it's bootleg, but you ever just have one of those days where, like, you know, you're in a global pandemic and you have to teach kids in person, but then there's a lot of kids out because they're sick, so they're home. So you have to make videos for them to do at home, because if you don't, then who's going to teach them the math? And there's a regents at the end of the year. Then you try to record and then all your technology doesn't work. You ever just have one of those days, or is that like too specific? Well, anyways, I'm still making a video. So we're going to graph and solve compound inequalities with and or. It's going to be separate though, so not in set builder form. That will be the next video. I'm also going to put a link in the comments and the description to graphing compound inequalities and like all the other information like set builder, roster, interval, yada yada. So I'm not gonna like fill out the entire worksheet today or like solve with you all of the questions today. I'm gonna do like examples 1 through 4, but then I'm not gonna do all the graph stuff with you because there's a video on how to do that also, but I will have an answer key and all that. So let's get started. All right. We've gone over like how to solve inequalities, how to graph compound inequalities. So now we're just going to kind of put that all together today. So the first thing I'm going to do here, this is an and situation. I can tell that because there's an and symbol in between. I can also see that there's like two separate inequalities. So it looks just like kind of an equation, a two-step equation that you're going to solve. So I'm going to go ahead. I like to split it at the sign. So the first inequality is here, 4v plus 3 is greater than negative 5. So I'm just going to go ahead and solve that one first. I like to put my ladder. I'm going to just solve it quick because we already know two steps. So subtract 3 to both sides. 4v is greater than negative 8. Watch those integers. And then v is greater than negative 2. When I start writing using symbols, I know that like this is and this is or, but since this variable is a V and I don't want to get confused, I'm going to use like the U-shape symbols for and or only because of this variable. If it was X, I wouldn't care which one you use. All right, let's solve the second one. Put the ladder, stay organized. Kids, on this side, on this particular inequality, negative 2v plus 7 is greater than 1. I like to make the prediction ahead of time. I already know I'm going to swap a sign because this unit right here is negative. So we'll get to that in a second, but you can already kind of know that before you even start the inequality. What do we have? Negative 6 here. Divide negative 2 to both sides. So this is where you have to swap the sign. Don't forget that from my previous videos or previous lessons we've done. So here, this greater than sign is going to turn into less than. And now the answer is V is less than 3, so not included. If I were going to say this now with symbols, so I have two separate inequalities here, which is the definition of a compound inequality. I can see that I want to put a symbol in between, and I know it's and, so I'm going to just write the first one and then put the and symbol in between. Again, since it's V, the variable, I'm going to use the U-shape type of symbols. So there's an and. And I will finish this one with you, and then the rest of it, I'm not going to do all this stuff. All right, I need to make sure that my graph has enough room for all of this on here. So I'm going to probably start with, like, let's say negative 4. Negative 3 all the way to, you know, fill up all the tick marks on your graph. All right, shortcut here. Since I already know it's and, there's a couple ways I can figure that out. First of all, the and symbol was here. The second way I can figure that out is because since this is the small number here and then the large number on the right, and then on that, both of these inequalities, that the V is on the left-hand side, you can see that these arrows here are like pointing towards each other. So you're going to shade in between. So let's circle the two numbers we're dealing with. Boom, boom. None of them are included, so I can't shade them. And now I'm going to just shade in between because it's and. All right, let's talk about what's in our roster. I understand it's like all real numbers, but if we were only going to be writing the integers, you have to draw your French braces. The first number that's included is negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. 3 is not included, so I don't add it. And then finish it up with the brace. All right, set builder. So the shortcut for a set builder, I know it's an and situation, which is important. So what I like to do is put the small number on the left, the variable in the middle, the larger number on the right. And now I understand those are not here in my set, but I'm going by like the original problem. Since it's an and situation, I'm going to put both of the inequalities as less than. And none of them are included, so I don't need the line underneath. Then I put the fancy pants stuff around it, so I got a line, a V, and then the braces. You don't need this stuff, but there's a possibility that you will see it on some of your worksheets that you do. All right, interval notation. High number is on the left, or I'm sorry, low number's on the left, high number on the right, and since neither one of them are included, they both get parentheses. If it were included, it would get a bracket, but neither one of these are, so that's that. All right, question 2. Okay, so in this situation, instead of like the word and or something like this, we have the actual like mathematical symbol of or, which looks like a U right here. So I like to split it at the symbol so I can just make sure I'm treating them separately. And now I'm just going to start solving my inequalities. So I'm going to put a ladder. And like this one for me is like gross. First of all, the variable is on the right, and I hate when the variable is on the right. I prefer it on the left, but I'm just going to leave it alone for now. I also noticed that there is a negative unit rate or coefficient on P. So since there's a negative unit rate, I know in the future I'm going to swap my sign. So this one's going to have like a double swap situation. You'll see towards the end. All right, let's subtract 1. Come back later. All right, negative 12. See, it's just one of those days. Can't get anything done. All right, negative 3P. Let's divide. This is the saucy part, guys. Because I have to swap the sign because I divided that negative. So look, I'm going to be dramatic. Swapped. Bring down P, and your answer is 4. I also don't like the inequality written with the variable on the right-hand side. Very fussy. So I'm going to flip-flop it so it's the way I like it. Pac-Man or Mrs. Pac-Man, look at how cute she is. She's got the little bow. She's so adorable. So she's eating P in this situation, not 4. So I'm going to put the P over here, put 4, and then swap that sign. So Mrs. Pac-Man is still facing the right direction. Look at her. Look at it. She's so adorable. Okay, so P is greater than or equal to 4. You could also say 4 is less than or equal to P, but I don't like that way because I don't like the variable on the right. So here is the answer. All right, for the next one, you actually don't have to do anything. It's already solved. You can see that here. It's P is less than 2. So since it's less than 2, I don't have to solve anything. It's done. I want to say it with symbols, though, first. However, the other part that's a little saucy here is that I like to put the smaller one on the left. So I'm going to put the smaller one on the left. We've got P is less than 2, and then the or symbol, which is the U, and then I've got P is greater than or equal to 4. I can tell it's an or for a couple of reasons. When we're in this particular format, Since we have this symbol here, I could see that it's 4. And also, if you take a look at the inequalities, that's pointing left and that's pointing right. So that means they're like going the opposite way. So that means you're gonna, you know, go or. So I'm not gonna graph this one yet. I'll graph it a little later. Let's continue on to question number 3. All right, question 3. Ooh, these ones are a little bit more saucier than questions 1 and 2. They're a little bit more difficult. All right, so let's set up the same way we did before. I'm gonna put a line where the symbol is. This symbol stands for and. You could even figure out that it's and if that symbol wasn't there. If these were just like 2 separate ones and you like set everything up the way we discussed in like previous videos and how I did 1 and 2, you'll see that this is gonna work out no matter what. Oh, let me change that color. Okay, so I'm splitting both inequalities separately. Ew, a fraction, I hate fractions. So I'm going to rewrite it so I have 2 fractions. I know that sounds crazy. Let's put our ladder, stay organized. I'm gonna actually change up 1/2 n. So 1/2 times n is the same thing as n divided by 2. I'm gonna throw the variable with the numerator, and 1 times n is just n. You don't have to put the 1. So it's n over 2 is less than, or I'm sorry, greater than. And then I'm going to put negative 2 over 1. So now I have 2 fractions. So that way I could cross multiply and not even think about taking reciprocals because I don't like that. All right, let's move some things around. N times 1 is 1n or n. But since I started, cross multiplication with an equal sign doesn't matter what side it ends up on. But when you're doing an inequality, it does matter because if the n is on the left to start, you have to keep it on the left. So I'm gonna go like this, n. Keep your symbol, and now I'm multiplying negative 2 times 2. If the 2 was negative on the denominator on this side, you would have to be switching signs around. But in this case, you don't. This side doesn't matter at this point. So I'm just gonna put negative 4 here. All right, that one's solved. N is greater than negative 4. All right, next one. All right, ladder. Ooh, we got variables on both sides. It's not too bad, though. You could rearrange or you can solve it using inverse properties. All right, we've got negative n, negative n. Do it to one side, do it to the other. A lot of people think that since I divided or I subtracted n to both sides that you're bringing over a negative and that you swap the sign, but that's not true here. It's only when you do it with multiplication and division, not subtraction property of equality. That does not apply for swapping signs. So 2n minus n is n minus 2 less than 6. Let's just finish this up. Add 2 to both sides. N is less than 8. Okay. All right, smaller one's already on the left, bigger one's already on the right. So when I say it with symbols, I can see that I'm gonna put this symbol here in between. It's already in the format that I like, meaning the variables on the left of each inequality. Also, the smaller ones on the left compared to the and symbol. And the and symbol, it looks like I'm gonna make a capital A. That's how we remember the difference. And then the bigger one is on the right-hand side. So we're in good shape. I could see that the arrows are like pointing towards each other, so it's gonna graph in between. Again, I'll graph it later. I'm not gonna do that now. All right, last one. Actually, this one's like pretty easy. This one's probably the easiest one on here, to be honest. All right, I'm just gonna draw a line at or. There's no symbol there, so we're gonna write it in later. Remember, or is like this. All right, ladder to stay organized. Add 1 to both sides. We've got 5x less than negative 25. Oh yeah, this one's super easy. Divide 5 to both sides. X is less than negative 5. All right, that one's done. Next one, I'm going to add 2 to both sides. Ladder. Oh yeah, this one's super easy. I don't know why I didn't put this one first. Oh, what am I doing? All right, Miss Pass, what is going on today? All right, this is 14. Divide. X is greater than or equal to 2. Yeah, that was so easy. There's like nothing saucy about that one at all. I didn't think of that. All right, let's say it with symbols. So we've got the small one. We've got the big one. And variables are both on the left, so we're in good shape. I could see that the arrows, look, they're pointing like that way and that way from the inequalities, like that shortcut. So since they're going opposite, I know it's or. It also said or, but, you know, shortcuts. I'm going to put my or symbol in between, which is either a U or a V. I think I used a U earlier, so in this case, I'll use a V just to mix it up a little bit. So now I'm just going to go through and finish solving the rest of them. I'm going to finish putting all the graphs and stuff. And I'm not going to say anything because if you want a how-to on that, again, I'm putting a link to graphing compound inequalities in the description. Alright, that's all we have today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Tell me I'm adorable. If you want a link to the notes, there it's in the description below. See you guys again real soon.